Hello everyone and welcome back. I am your host, Elias Antopoulos. In After Effects, we apply a hold keyframe to change the value of a layer property over time, but without a gradual transition. So it holds a layer on a specific keyframe. So let's see how this works inside After Effects. The idea for this animation is to drop this botanic flower from the top using the Y position, then make it hold for a second, let's say, then move it to the right using the X position. So first I'm going to target this botanic garden flower JPEG. I'm going to press P on my keyboard to bring up the position property, which actually I'm going to split this position property. So we have two different parameters. So all you have to do is just right-click and then use the separate dimensions function here. And now we can keyframe those two X position and Y position independently of one another. So I'm in the beginning of the timeline here. And first I'm going to target the X position. So I'm going to create a keyframe first here on the X position. So click on the stopwatch. And I'm going to scrub this to the first second. And I'm going to create another keyframe here. So just click on that. And now we have two identical keyframes. Okay, now I'm going to jump on the first keyframe. So I'm going to press the letter J on my keyboard. And then I'm going to click and drag this up. And I'm holding the shift key as I do, like so. Okay. All right, now I'm going to go to the next keyframe. So I'm going to press the letter K on my keyboard. And now I'm going to have another keyframe, but this time on the X position. So click on the stopwatch and then move this playhead to, let's say, 3 seconds. And then I'm going to scrub this value like so. So if I play this, press the space bar, I have a quite boring animation. Okay. So let's go ahead and spice things up. So first I'm going to select this second keyframe on the Y position. Go up to the animation menu, keyframe assistant, easy is in. Okay, so when this comes in, there is an ease to it. Okay, all right, now I actually want to fine tune how this motion behaves even more. I'm talking about this motion here, this ease in. So for that, I'm going to bring up the graph editor. And if I click on the graph type, this is going to be outside your screen. I am inside the value graph, okay? So this handle right here is the influence handle. So I'm going to grab this and I'm going to push this off into space. And as I do, pay attention right here. I'm creating something called overshoot. Okay. All right. So let's play this for a second. Comes in, overshoots, and then moves. All right. Now, the goal here is actually after the overshoot, it stays for a second or so, and then it moves to the next keyframe. So you might think, oh, let me go and duplicate this keyframe, place it further onto the timeline before the next keyframe. And since it's identical, it will hold its value. So let's try that. Let's select this keyframe. Control-C or Command-C. And then let's go ahead and paste this. Control V or Command V. And now we have this issue here. We have this wobbling effect, you see? And that's not what we want. So Control Z or Command Z to undo. How about if we select those two, copy those, and place those here? Let's try that. Press the space bar. And whoops, we have another issue here. It bounces twice. Again, that's not what we want. In other words, the problem with this approach is that a lot can happen between those keyframes. In this case, things are moving in between and keyframes are not holding. The right approach is to change the keyframe interpolation type to a hold keyframe. So we are going to select the keyframe that is supposed to hold its value, which is this one. And then from an ease in keyframe animation, we are going to turn this into a hold in keyframe. So it holds on a value until it hits the next keyframe. And there's a couple of ways you can do this. Right click and use the toggle hold keyframe, or let me go ahead and undo this. We can use the keyboard shortcut, which is Control Alt H or Command Option H, like so. Let's try this animation. There you go. There's a delay, and then it moves to the next keyframe. Let's also create another overshoot bounce back. I'm going to select the last keyframe on the X position, go up to the animation menu, keyframe assistant, and use Easy Ease In. Now return back to the graph editor, inside the value graph, take the influence handle and push it off to space by looking at the motion path. Perhaps something like this, let's see. Moves in, there's a delay, and then we have another overshoot here. Okay, so let's play this one more time. It holds and then it goes to the next keyframe. So hold keyframes are great for creating more rhythmic animations, and they can be used for any property or effect, like a freeze a video clip or create jumping movements or what have you. Thank you for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions below the comments section. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share the knowledge.